is up, guys? Protopilot here, and today we are going to be reviewing another fighter jet world, but this time we're going to change it up and we're going to do a carrier world. This world, as you can see on aircraft carrier jets, F-14. Rolling with F-14s, they have SU-30s, UH-60s, let's see what else they have. They have V-22 Osprey, KC-10, fuel tanker, and they do have AA guns scattered around the map with A refueling aircrafts constantly circling the map that this game has to offer. Now, we're gonna go ahead and make a public world here. And we are going to go ahead and jump right in this. Alright guys, we are in the world here, and I forgot to mention, that's the F-14 carrier. And over here is the, let's just call it the VTOL carrier, with you got helicopter, two Harriers, and the Osprey is right in the front here. So, what we are going to do is go ahead and get in one of these F-14s and take flight. And my avatar stays the same, perfect. Alright, we're gonna hook up to this catapult here. We're gonna have full afterburner. And we're gonna take off here. You guys know what I should do? I should set up a camera on the top of the carrier. That's what I'm gonna do. But first, I am going to... I noticed there was a balloon up there. Perfect. I'm going to begin a carrier landing. I'm going to start with our approach here. Align with those runway lights. Maintain it. We save it. Perfect. That was a pretty nice landing. I'm gonna set up my camera really quickly. Alright guys, I have my camera set up here. We're gonna get in our aircraft. Full afterburner and send it off the carrier. Awesome. Absolutely. Alright. People who do plan a dogfight with the F-14, just remember, this isn't the MiG-29 like you saw in the last video. If you plan to use up all your energy in one single circle dogfight, then you are sadly mistaken when using the F-14. Because if you lose all your energy, there is a 40% chance you'll save yourself from that stall. And unfortunately for us, we don't have to worry about blackouts in this world. But I'm getting pretty used to blackouts, and like I said in the last video, I did turn off my usernames here. So I have to track by radar and voice from now on, you know, just to add sort of a difficulty there. Gonna do a low pass over both carriers. I am going about 970 knots here. As you can see, the cockpit begins to shake when you enter the stall speed or when you start to gravely lose energy. Take off. Over here, the SU-30s. Let's see. So yeah, we just passed the SU-30s back there. We got our sonic boom cone here. And I explained all the aircraft on the carrier we flew over to. But the next one we're gonna be flying is the Sea Harrier. I'm gonna do a landing, quick landing here. Keep that 200 knot. Uh-oh. Guys, I don't know what just happened. All right, guys. We are at the Harriers now. And as you can see, this is a heavily armed piece of art here. All right, guys. I know you guys want to check out my VTOL skills, so I'm going to go ahead and put this in VTOL here. And uh-oh, a little rocky. All right. Let's go ahead and use this rudder to our advantage here. You guys want me to hop from one carrier to another? I can do that. Oh, that is easy. Watch and learn. Perfect landing. Attempt to take off from this angle. I'm gonna put it in quarter of the way. All right, folks, we're gonna do a flyby here. Interesting. Harrier is a energy-based aircraft. What I'm trying to say is, if you're in a single circle with this thing and you let it regain its energy, then that's pretty much a death wish, pal. Death wish. So, yeah, if you are good at single circles and regaining energy, then don't use this. Use the F-14. But if you need some help with that, start off with the Harrier, because it is quite literally just training wheels. Now, this thing does not have a hook, so let's see what we're gonna do here. We are going to. All right, we're gonna fly up to the carrier. Zero throttle. Toggle VTOL. Go back to brake. Full throttle. Keep braking. And that's how we do, or how I do, my VTOL approach to this aircraft carrier. Uh-oh. Whoa. That was sudden. All right, I'm gonna try to shift it around. Oh gosh. Back up. Keep backing up. Keep going. Here, let me. No, that will propel me forward. I need to keep backing up. All right, this is good enough. All right, let's see here. Let's go ahead to the Osprey. You might be wondering why I keep skipping the helicopters. Well, that's because I'm trash at flying helicopters, and that is not good content, and if all you do is watch someone crash. So, what we're gonna do here. No. Okay. That is a giant throttle stick. I don't know how, you know, those Navy pilots do it, but, you know, they do what they do, and nobody knows what they do, so. Let's see, how do these flares look? Oh, that's majestic. It looks like a child wailing his arms around and slopping popsicle juice all over the place. Oh lord, folks, we're gonna hit the ground without any gear. That's cool. Now you see, in a past update, they had the Osprey and another helicopter at these two helipads that you are seeing in front of you right now. That's the canopy. Where's the brake? There is no brake. Okay. We're just gonna reverse. Yeah, just reverse. Alright, now. Now you just dip forward. Yeah, just dip. Okay, perfect. Now, you don't land here. You land right here. Awesome. Look at that landing, guys. That is majestic. Moving on, we have the Su-30s here. A fierce Russian aircraft built for maneuverability and maneuverability. Let's get in this bad boy. Now, what I like to do is a little bit of acrobatics. I'll show you guys what I mean. Hold on, I have an idea, guys. Don't worry, it's gonna be safe. It's gonna be very safe. Watch this, guys. Now, if we could just... That's smoke. Yes. As you can see, we are doing the one I call ballerina dance, where you rapidly descend altitude, and then you save it, and then you just, like, hover there while spinning. And, right, so you hover through your past smoke, and then you go zero throttle, use your brake like crazy, and you just pull a couple of little spins there. And then you hover back over to your past smoke, and you, like, just start spinning, like, just straight spinning. So then, you, like, pull a bit of a backwards cobra, and just hover, right? So then, what we're gonna do is do something a little different here. Retract flaps and gear. Use brake to descend. And we're gonna kinda like hover past the camera. That is, if we can survive, which we cannot. We're back in the air. No silly doodle smoke stuff now. We are going. This is insane! Folks, how? How am I doing this? This is not true. This is untrue. This can't be done. This is illegal. No, oh, we can't die at this. Wow, little spin to save my life? Wow, that's pretty cool. Oh my gosh, folks, this is absolutely amazing. I never thought the SU-30 was capable of this. I know they don't do this in air shows. They're too trash. Alright, folks, listen up. We're going to try that again, but we're not going to do any of the ballerina recital stuff, okay? Hopefully, we don't. Folks, we have a cobra into a hover. Come on. Don't fumble me now. Crazy stuff we got here. I'm gonna try to hover over to the camera with the mouse. Where's the camera? I lost it. I don't know where it is. It's gone. Okay, it's back this way. No. Folks, no! Not again! No! This can't be! This can't be! But it's so tempting! It's so tempting! Oh yeah, I'm built different. Look at those spins, golly! Bro, this is some 5th gen stuff right here. Alright, no more ballerina stuff, I swear. But you know what I am gonna do. I'm going to attempt a landing on the aircraft carrier without a hook. I've done it before, I swear. It was like a little cobra landing. It was cool. It was crazy. It was awesome. I used to be interested in trains, and then those things got boring. And then I thought maybe you could fly and take passengers with you. It's like a flying train. As you can see, I'm not good with landings, like, at all, but I in the last video, I did butter a lot, and it was great, it was awesome. And I know you guys want to see me fly helicopter, so. Here we go. To the people who want to laugh at me, I'm getting in a helicopter. You better clip this. Okay, great. Hit. Oh gosh. This rudder is knocking me off course so badly. It's knocking me so far off course that I just barely scraped the surface of the water. Alright, folks. Whew. We survived. I mean, we landed. Yes, that was such a butter. Alright, kids, former pilots, the 60-year-olds that watch my videos, I'm gonna put a picture that shows all the people, the age groups of everyone that watches my videos. It's actually scary, because my videos are intended for 18 and lower, so all the 30, 40-year-olds that are watching my videos, you can go ahead and click off right now. 18 and lower, guys. 18 and lower. 18's not even... It really should be like 15 and lower. 18 is... 18 is a short-term acceptance. Well, that's aircraft carrier jets with you guys. We didn't get to dogfight today. People are too scared to join my server. And, like I said in the last video, friend me. I want to dogfight you. I want to see your skill. I want to teach you. Not like I'm any better, but I want to dogfight you guys. I want to get skill as well. So, if you guys happen to see my videos and say, oh, I want to dogfight him, put your username in the comments. Make sure it's your exact username. I will friend you. And, oh, we can dogfight. We can even make videos together. You guys can be in videos. Who doesn't want that? And also, join my Discord. Discord's fun and cool. And, I'm not from Canada. Let's see. F-14's okay. Very good, actually. Harrier's very good. Helicopter, bad. SU-30, awesome. And other than that, I'll see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, don't turn on post notifications. And everyone, have a great day. Peace!